This side Abhishek from Digital Learning Magazine. Right now we have a Mansi Agarwal, Director, Scottish Early Years, one of the most premium preschools. So Mansi ma'am, once a straight question, share me about your mission and the motto of your preschool, ma'am.
I think the mission and the motto of my preschool is to provide quality education. So value-based education, early childhood education being such a strong impact, in the life of children and such a crucial learning age, that I feel that the more values we can instill in them and the more exposure we can give them, it'll help them expand their horizons. So that's our motto, just value-based education and quality education.
And Mansi ma'am, right now the preschooler is dealing with the parents more than the children. So how we are bridging the gap between the educators, your teachers, parents and the children's of almost like 3 years, 2 years, 4 years. So how you are bridging that gap so that all the people is on the same platform and the technology is also enabled your preschool and the parents has a equal knowledge that what preschool is doing and what my children is learning. So how are you bridging that gap, ma'am?
See, the concept of bridging the gap is very simple. We never have an issue with the child because the old school methodologies work perfect with children. Now we are using technology to ensure we bridge the gap, be it an app-based system to ensure there is perfect communication, daily communication between the facilitator in the class and the parents, be it daily diary notes, be it organizing, at least one monthly event where the parent gets to come to the school, see what the children are doing in their class, and participate with their child. I think that helps really bridge the gap and ensure that communication is going very well. 12 events in a year, 12 good events which involve parents coming within the classroom, participating with children performing for the parents. I think just regular face-to-face communication also, then of course we'd get concern calling also done. So ensuring that at least once in 2 months a call goes from the director's office asking if everything's okay, if they have any complaints or concerns. That's what we do to bridge the gap.
And Mansi ma'am, one last question. What innovation you have done for your preschool curriculum regarding your safety and security of children, ma'am? This is the one most any precautions every school is doing. What innovation you have done regarding the safety and security?
See, I think innovation is a strong word to use, but inventing is difficult, but implementing a lot that is going on around and a combination of it is something that we can hope to do. So be it the child coming and the teacher marking the attendance in an app which directly sends a message to the parent saying your child has reached and is present in school. The same when the child leaves, that your child has left. Some RFID processes when the child comes to school, so for swiping, making sure there are, the infrastructure is developed in a child-friendly way. There's antibacterial soft flooring, the sanitary, the hygiene is there, it's made sure that it's maintained, be it the bathrooms and the washrooms, that they are child friendly and child size. So there are all these things combined make sure that we implement a good safety and hygiene standard for children. So we try and do a little of all, making sure be it the pick up cards, not giving the parent the child or not giving an individual their child without a proper card. Very small things, but very important in the whole process of making sure that the child is safe and secure.
Thank you, Mansi ma'am. Thank you for joining School Leadership Summit.
Thank
and stay tuned with us.